So now for the exciting part of the project, we got to do some grafting. Now the interesting thing is you just don't want to be grafting any old random ass bee from any old where. You want to be getting some that you're enjoying to work with and they are productive and they like to keep their hive clean and they're not too bad at multiplying on their own. And the interesting thing is my lovely wife has a bee box in her backyard, which has a very much of the qualities that we want, and hence why they got put here, because they were beautiful and they're productive and they've come out of the apiary and they've ended up here in this luxurious yard that the lovely wife's created for them. But just right now, we're going to go in there and we're going to borrow some of their progeny. So this is how this is done. Charge! Now this little box on the top here was one of our original splits that we've done. It acts on its destination to another spot, but it's still sitting here because, I don't know, time just gets away from a bloke, doesn't it? So we're just going to take that off, even though they're all the same. Oh, gals, you're doing a good job in there. And we'll just pop our lid off. Oh, the little bees in paradise. Give them a little smoke and wake for a second. Hello, they say, what the hell? It's on fire. Everybody run for the hills. Or something along those lines, anyway. Howdy-ho, chicky babes. Let's pop you out of there. The super off the top. So now what we've got to do is find the right age eggs. We've given these girls a little bit of extra food to make them nice and happy. But what we're looking for is some young larva ages, probably a day or two old. So, because obviously the queen comes along, she lays an egg. It's an egg for about 3 days and then they hatch out into a little larvae and the girls start feeding them. We want some of that young larvae because after it's 3 days old, you can't turn it into a queen. But before then, ideal. So we want some young larvae with a little bit of royal jelly in the bottom of the pot, and then we're going to go and graft that out and stick it in some artificial queen cells, which we're going to take over to our cell raising box. Now if you weren't confused, you probably are now, but anyway, what right now, we're just looking for some young larvae that we can graft. Obviously you could isolate the queen and get all excited and do that too, so, but right now we're not doing that because I haven't. Right, a little bit of smoke, of course. Smoke's always good. Woo-wee! Yeah, smoking like Cheech and Chong. Right, so we're just gonna wriggle things apart here a little bit. Usually you want to start from the outside. As a general rule, the stuff you're looking for is generally towards the middle, but not always. You just don't know, because this has got some new frames in here. They've just worked this out. Oh, there's some young stuff in the corner. But that's not gonna be enough. We'll just shake her off. What do we got? We got anybody important there? Nobody important. Just don't lose the queen, because especially if she's going to be a breeder queen, you just don't want to lose the queen, or it's the real F on the report card. I think that's just a honey frame. That feels like nice cup brood, which is no good to us. Nope, that's no good. We don't want that. Looking for the one that we want. Oh, it's a mystery. That all looks pretty promising too, but it's not what we want. Nope, they're all too old. Luckily for us, generally speaking, the queen works across the box a little bit at a time, and it will lay up a whole heap in the one spot. We're going to have to go over in the sun because I can't see for shit. Hang on. Oh my goodness, me, I'm old. Oh, here we go. This is what we're looking for. So you can see that the boss has just laid around the edge of some brood that she's got going on, and she'll, as you go further from the young, from the older larvae, it gets younger and younger and younger, and there's some nice eggs and nice young larvae out here, which is what we're hopefully going to get a few of. But I've got to go get my glasses, so I should put my glasses on when I do this part of the project, but still, I think we will get away with that.
This is where the fun begins. Now don't try to do this if you've had a big night the night before, because otherwise you'll have the DTs and you'll be doing that, and it's never quite right. So you've got to have a little bit of a good, no, what is it, a good constitution? No, that's not the right word. But anyway, here we go. This is the fun part. Right, so we've brought our frame in from the beehive. We've got ourselves just basically a little Fowler's office desk. This is basically the thing that you'd put your laptop on or your laptop screen on, which is pretty straightforward. Get that from the office shop. Got ourselves a nice little bright light. You can have a light on your head if you want. I tried having a light in my head, but it didn't really work out for me because it shone on my glasses and then I didn't know what I was doing. Some people have a big magnifying glass. I don't need a magnifying glass because I'm not completely blind. But you also You want to get your queen cells. They're going to be stuck on this bar that's going to go in your frame holder or your cell hanger or whatever terminology you want to use. So we've basically just got some hot wax and stuck these cell caps on here, which are going to make the girls think that they're raising queens, which is what we're hoping to achieve. And there's a myriad of jolly queen grafting tools. Man, I tell you what, these are little cheap-ass Chinese ones that are just, you can buy a bag full of them for $20. And if they're no good, you chuck them away and you get one that does work. This one happens to be half reasonable. You can get a fancy half silver thing like this, which is like a little scoopy spoon. The only trouble is I have a little bit of trouble. I find these really good for getting the grub out. Just getting the grub off is a bit of fun. So I don't know. And this one that looks like a nail file is the bit that you're meant to be able to scrape the grub off of the metal one. But I don't know. I haven't had much success for that. So I've gone back to this cheap ass jolly little tool. And if you get your grub on the end of this flexible little bit, and you just slide them off into the queen cup. And then there's a little bit of royal jelly in there to hold them in that. And then you put it in your cell raiser and then hey presto, you've got a whole heap of queens. Or maybe hey presto, you've got a whole heap of nothing. It just depends. Look at that. We've got a girl trying to get, nope, she's just getting born right now.
Hello, hello, I want to come out and say hello to the world.
Hello, little one. Welcome to the world. She's wondering where all her sisters are. It's like, what the hell happened? What am I doing in here? You'd call that day one of her life, wouldn't you? Now we have to be very nice to her and get her back in the hive so she can have a good life. Whew, the whole 2 weeks, 2 months of it anyway. Rightio. So the age you're looking for is roughly a young 2 day old one. You want some nice royal jelly at the bottom of your cell though, so that you can actually get the jolly thing out. If it's too dry, nothing's gonna happen. You don't want an egg because that'll just fall out of your frame, out of your holder anyway. So you got to get a young grub with some nice moisture. And there's a couple of nice ones just here. But the fun part is getting them on the end of this and getting them in here. That's a bit of an experience in itself. Okay, so you don't want an egg, which is just that little one there. You don't want a grub that's too big, but you want one that's the right age, which is interesting. You could get all excited and lock the queen up into one frame and then you'd have them all the right age, but I haven't got that motivated because, you know, it is the Bush Bee Man show after all. Let's not get carried away. Right, so now for the fun part to try and scoop it out. I always find it a bit interesting to find out where the depth of this jolly thing is for a start. Getting her on the jolly end of it is never as easy as it should be because I can't quite see what I'm doing because I'm old and blind. There we get her out like that. And see, you've got a little grub on the end of your... So you get your little grub and then you pop it in the cell. You want to try and get it in the middle of the cell because obviously with the if it was getting laid in there, it would... get in the middle of the cell, wouldn't it? Because the queen's pretty clever. I don't know how she actually gets it perfectly in the middle, but she has a little tiny bit of glue when she puts an egg in the cell, so it just holds it to the bottom of the cell, even though the cell technically is on an angle. So, but you never see an egg laying at the bottom of the cell. It's always like on the horizontal, so it's obviously stuck there a little bit, which is kind of clever. So anyway, we're just trying to mimic nature here. Just trying to influence the situation in our favour. If you just do a normal split without all this carry-on, you'd probably generate, I don't know, somewhere between one and six cells, queen cells that you could use. That would be all right, but it's also a jolly awkwardness to actually place them in the hive that you want them in. Whereas this way, you've got this cool plastic cup that you can push into the hive pretty much. The idea of going to all this trouble is, of course, instead of getting 5 queen cells, you're going to get 20 out of the prodigy if you don't do that to them. Because if you do that to them, you'll get nothing. Which is roll them up the side of the cell. Don't roll them up the side of the cell when you're doing this. And if you happen to roll them up the side of the cell, just move on, because it's not going to be very healthy, because they're very, very delicate. So we're going to pop our little larvae in our cell. And then I just like to keep them moist, a little bit of wet paper towel over the top. It's also so you know where you're up to, because otherwise you're a little bit awkward like me. You forget which cell you've got them in, and you look in there and you go, shit, now there's 2 or 3 in there. And then that's not very productive. So you just want one in every cell, even though they're not all, well, some of the professionals, of course, will get everyone to take. I am just happy if I get more than half. Probably not a high standard to set myself, but it's all right. My old man's a dustman, he wears a dustman's hat. I think the interesting thing about bees is that they decide what we are going to get right. It's a very interesting little dilemma.
Oh, I don't know. Come on, girls, come out of there.
If you're ever going to be silly enough to go rearing queens or grafting queens, don't get too disappointed at the first lap, because it's a bit of an ongoing project. It's not as easy as you might think. It's definitely not as easy as I thought it might be. As I was hoping it was going to be. Later on in the, well, it is, at least it's the same day, not in, later on next week. We're actually going to take our queen hanger and we're going to hang it in our queen rearing hive, and hopefully we'll get some cells to take, and then we'll have some gels to multiply the bee population of the world. How good would that be? Huh. If you've just arrived here at the Bush Bee Man Show, go back one episode and you'll see us get organised to create the hive that we're about to put the queen hanger in. So then you won't get lost. So this little cool little device is where you hang your bars. So you put your queen cups in these little notches, which when the girls make a queen cell, they actually have it hanging down. And so this is to imitate their natural reaction. I'm just going to leave the paper on there because it's got a bit warm here in the Riverland. So we'll just leave that on there until we get out to where we're going. You don't want your little ladies to dry out. So you got your little bars that just slip into those little holes with all your little queen cups on.
And then we're going to go back and pop them in and let the ladies do their magic.
We might have to come back for the sugar water, but anyway.
One thing at a time.
So this here is one of our cell raisers that we've set up. We've got a few of these laying around the place, but anyway, this is one of the better ones. The interesting things with, and I've forgotten my smoker, the interesting thing with bees is that everybody's good at different things, and this particular hive seems to be really good at raising cells. I probably bloody burnt the entire bag that I had sitting over here. Me smoker got a bit hot because I left me bag burning with the lid open. So she's like, wow, don't do that. Plus it's been sitting in the sun. Now just to make sure your smoke's not too hot, if you happen to have hot smoke like we have at the minute, just do it from a bit further away or get some grass and stuff in there. But anyway, you know, what I used to say to my kids, do as I tell you, don't do as I do. It's a safe option. As you would remember, this is our divider board. So we've actually turned the box around and we've got some nice nurse bees at the top of the box here. We've got our divider board so the girls think they're queenless. And what we're going to do is we're going to pop our queens raising cells in here. And then the theory is that the girls will raise some queen cells for us. Then we'll be able to go and put those cells in some other hives. And look out, we'll have lots more bees. In theory, anyway. As long as the poor little virgin gets back home from a mating flight. But that's a whole nother saga. I didn't bring my hive tool back, did I? Fucking hell, I'm on a roll, John. Stay there.
Bloody shit.
Oh, stop it. Forget my head if it wasn't sewn on.
Pop this off here a little bit. Just be nice and relaxed. Everybody's a bit excited. Hey, girls, hello. Making you work hard, we are.
So what we want to do is we want to find out where the brood is in here. I think I've got honey over this side, so we're going to have to get rid of some of that because we've got to put an extra frame in here. So we're going to take that out of there. That one's not quite finished off, which is a bum. It's all right, we can give it back to them anyway. That's not...
Oh, which one are we going to take, John? Which one are we going to take? Any good ideas? That one. Okay, ladies, I know, I don't like me either. What the hell, they said. Who's this in our kitchen? Get off, you bloody polar bears.
These bees are not the friendliest girls ever, but they're good for this cell raising job, so they've got a reprieve. They've found themselves a purpose. So we're going to push the honey out the way. And then what you're looking for is some nice brood like that. See that nice brood frame on both sides? You got some nice brood. Oh, I'm just double checking we haven't got any queens here getting raised that we don't want. And we've got some more brood in this one. You see there's nice brood in there.
Rightio.
So now the plan we're working on
So you've got two bits of brood. I think this one here is a bit of brood as well, but that doesn't matter. Yeah, some more on that one, which is cool. So we've got three frames. What we want to do is we want to put our cell raiser in between both, like in between the brood chamber, because that's where the nurse bees are going to be most active, and we want them to get most excited and feed our cells. And we're going to pop that in there, take our paper towel off. The plan is that we're going to slide this frame nice and gently in between all the bees that are all excited in here. And we're just going to push that frame up next to it a bit. There, like I said, these are not the friendliest bees you're ever going to meet, but that's all right. That's good for this job. Right, now, the next excitement is we're going to give them some sugar syrup. Just be a little cautious when you're pouring sugar syrup and you've got your feeder in your hive and you're pouring it in there. There's a couple of options. So I've only just stole my wife's jug and her funnel, but actually what you should have is a little tub, little pot with a spout. Or if you're doing this really seriously, you'll have a great big pot and a fuel thing and you fill up your feeder. But we haven't got any of that, so use your imagination. Just, anyway, I bring that up to say don't spill too much sugar and shit all over everything, because otherwise all you'll end up with a whole heap of ants, and they'll turn up, and then the girls, instead of raising queen cells, they'll be having a war with the ants, and that's just not what you need. Right, so let's be a bit careful. So we'll just be a bit careful. We'll take this stupid jug that I dislike. Even though I've stolen it, it annoys the crap out of me. So I might have to go down the street and buy my own jug. Hell, that'd be out of character though, wouldn't it? Oh, come on, you beast. Right, funnel in. Here goes our one-to-one sugar syrup. Don't get too blooming impatient.
It'd be anything like you, would it?
Never. Now, if you have happened to have stolen your wife's jug, don't put the bloody thing in the shed and leave it to get out there and get all grubby and then find out one day in the future, not too distant future, that you're asked, where the bloody hell's my jug? And you go, I don't know, darling. And you're thinking to yourself, I swear I've used it, but I don't know where I left it. And you go out and you find it, and it is all covered in ants, and that's never a good idea. It all ends poorly. So be a responsible beekeeper, or at the very least, a responsible husband. Anyway, so there we go. So the girls have got some sugar. The girls have got some eggs. All we need now is some good luck. And we'll pop our lid back on. Try not to wreck anybody. Good girls. Now, make me some queens. Make me some queens, babies. You can do it. Now, this is what calls, how does that go? This calls for patience. Now, you technically have to wait 10 days, but you're allowed to come back here in about 2 days and have a look and see what happened, and you'll know what took. Because I'll have them ripened up in about 5 or 6 days. I've had the cell covered pretty much. But on the 10th day, now, if you don't take them out on the 10th day, on the 11th day, you're just as likely to have one hatch and she'll eat everybody, and then you'll get nothing. So you'll have a success and a failure. I've done that and played that game. Me and the wife were having a competition, and I got up on our first time ever, and I got a whole 8, and she got 7, and I'm like, oh, I'm being a smart ass, and I was all clever and all the rest of it, and she's going, nah, nah, get off with you. And then on the 10th, it was the 10th day, I swear it was the 10th day, but anyway, I didn't get organised until the afternoon, and I must have had an older grub that decided to hatch out, and she ate everybody, so everybody was dead, except for my wife's one queen. Of course, I technically lost, so I don't think that's fair, but so just remember, 10 days is the rule. 10 days from the graft, get them out. So with the magic of you and our chew bang, next week, which will probably be technically 10 days away, maybe we could play little for a whole bloody 10 days. That'd stir the shit out of you, wouldn't it? But we're not going to do that. So come back and check out whether we had a win or not. Charge! Take my jug back inside. Thank you all for your viewing. Oh, that's right. If you'd like to help me get myself a new jug, don't forget, click like, subscribe, tell your mates. Hell, share the love. You never know, you might become a crazy beekeeper yourself.